As-Salam alaykum. In this video, I wanted to share with you an interesting miracle of the Quran. I think it is a miracle, and you can tell me then what you think about it, and then reflect a little bit on it. And this miracle is on the verse of the Quran, which you will find in the comments below, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes how basically the interaction between Pharaoh and Moses, Musa alayhi salam, and how the interaction left an impact on Pharaoh, so much so that Pharaoh said, look, I want to meet this God of Moses. And he spoke with Haman, the master mason, and he told him, look, go there and build for, or one of his leaders anyway, and build for me this building. This, you could say a pyramid, but you could say, you know, a big building, because the term used is very peculiar, but it is not the scope of it. But there is a specific methodology that the Quran highlights, in the sense that it tells us, it decides to tell us what Pharaoh actually said as far as the method of building this building is concerned, and that is to take tin and to cook it. So Pharaoh says, oh Haman, take some tin, cook it and whatever, and just build me this building. So what's being said here is that the process of building the pharaonic buildings is actually an artificial one. And not only that, it even describes as this procedure. You take a mixture of tin, which includes clay, may include limestone and similar other tinny materials, because it's a very specific term, and then you mix it with water, because tin has also that meaning of being, you know, like dirt, but specifically clay dirt, not just dirt made up of clay substances. And then Pharaoh says, take this and cook it. Now, the interesting thing, and there are a number of websites that report it, like Answering Christianity, they remind us that only in 2006 it became more official that there is a theory by this professor on important biopolymer institutes, I think, which is called Davidovits, and I will put all the references in the comments. Now, Davidovits proposed that actually because the dominating theory throughout history, as far as archaeology is concerned, as far as the study of pyramid and their architecture is concerned, is that the stones made to build these pharaonic buildings were actually natural, and they were carved and then put there. But what Davidovits proposed is that no, maybe they are maybe they're not natural and carved, maybe they are artificial. And nobody listened to him until finally another professor from one of the articles, I don't want to go too much into detail, but you will find all the references in the description. One of these professors, he received basically a call from someone one day, and it's not Davidovits, it's another one. And when he heard about this theory from Davidovits and so on, he burst out laughing. And he said, how come nobody ever used an electron microscope to just see the composition of the material? And what he discovered is that actually nobody did it. And when he did, they discovered that the mixture that made up the pyramid, the pyramidal stones were actually artificial, and they were made up of a mixture of water, limestone, and clay. So one of the theory which I read from Davidovits of how they would do it, because this professor then wondered, how in the world is it possible that we never found the tools that they used? Not one tool did they find from the building of these buildings. And if they find it, it's very scarce. Where are all the tools? Well, the proposal of Davidovits is that, for instance, they used buckets with liquid, tin, basically. And then this tin was cooked so that the vapor would go out, the water would evaporate, and they would become straight. So if you put it, like, it's like a liquid cake, you put it in a box that has a certain shape, then you cook it, and then when you cook it and finish cooking it, the bake will have that shape. And it's the same thing here with this tin. And indeed, despite nobody knowing this for millennia, from I would say more than 4,000 years ago, the Quran told this, told us this 1000 a bit more than 1400 years ago. So this is indeed a miracle. And the reflection instead that I want to do it, the mirror reflection as a Muslim community, is that where were the Muslim archaeologists? As far as I know, there's only one Muslim archaeologist that did some research, an interesting proto-research on hieroglyphs. But what if the people that discovered these things were us? What if it was the Muslims that actually read the book and, you know, they would start their research by saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and they would quote this verse of the Quran, and then scientifically they would go on to prove this scientific theory as true, which is now a fact basically, as you will see in the from the articles that I quote, and then proving the Quran true at the same time. With this, I finish this video with the greetings of peace of Islam. As-Salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace of God be with you and His mercy and His blessings. Until next time.